when I said that we use molecular markers to screen for resistance to disease, well, you can say it's one or two markers. But, you know, the thing with disease is that after a while, the pathogen may evolve and become more resistant and will overcome the resistance inherent in the plant. So, but when you have more than one or two genes, you kind of accumulate them in one variety or in a group of varieties. That is called pyramiding. So when you accumulate them there, they tend to, you know, support each other in resisting. So there will be a synergistic relationship or synergistic action in providing stability in resistance. That is what we want to do, so that our varieties will not succumb easily to mosaic disease, for example. We're also working with our partners in Tanzania and in IITA on cassava brown streak disease. We want to validate markers already developed by them in different genetic backgrounds with different populations. Those will help us identify which ones are newer sources of resistance to cassava brown streak disease, which is devastating the entire eastern and southern Africa. So that is the kind of work we are doing in the pyramiding of resistance genes. There are two international centers that work on cassava, the International Center for Tropical Agriculture, SIAT in Colombia, and the International Institute for Tropical Agriculture, IITA at Ibadan. The GCP has been able to help us to forge a relationship that is mutual and is sustainable in the area of molecular breeding. The GCP has also encouraged us, and there's respect for each other now, and we can work better, and everybody will have clearly defined goals and roles in projects. That was done through the GCP, and it has even rubbed off on other newer projects because of that standard set by the GCP. It has helped relationships so we can work better. It has helped to be more focused. It has helped to empower the NAS more, because now we will not just be at the receiving end of finished product, we also participate in developing technology. So that has really helped us to link up with the outside world, and having seen that kind of relationship working, we've been able to move on to places like Cornell University, Donald Danforth Plant Science Center in the US, and many other places, the ETH. So we collaborate with this in US and Europe. There's the relationship that exists between NAS in Africa that GCP has really helped us to forge. It's stronger now. We go directly to a NAS in Tanzania. We support each other. They call it South-South collaboration, and the GCP has done all that and is very helpful.